Have you ever thought that you can make a complete Spring Boot microservice without writing a single line of code? Of course, I'm not talking about copying or downloading it from somewhere, but you can make your own microservice using GitHub Copilot by just giving a simple prompt. In this video, I'll guide you how you can make your own microservice project with all the CRUD operations. Each layer here will have all its clear responsibilities. We'll be using in-memory database to save our student entity, and we'll be following this class diagram along. Before we install Copilot on IntelliJ, you need an active subscription to get GitHub Copilot running on your IDE. The real cost of owning GitHub Copilot can be around $10 per month. To get it for free, you can follow the link in the description where I have explained step-by-step ways to get GitHub Copilot for free. So now let's start with this video. I'll be using IntelliJ here. Open IntelliJ settings by pressing Ctrl+Alt+S and click on plugin. And in the plugin, click on marketplace and search for GitHub Copilot. Click on install. It's installing. And yes, it's installed. Click on restart IDE. And once your IDE gets restarted, click on login to GitHub. You'll get a device code, just copy it, copy and open. I've already logged into my GitHub account, so I'll just paste this code and click on continue. So it's asking for permission, I'll authorize it. And then if I click on login to GitHub Copilot, now I'm signed into my GitHub Copilot. So now let's create Spring Boot application structure via Spring Initializer. So we'll go to start.spring.io, choose Maven. Write down the group name as GitHub Copilot demo, change the artifact name, and then add the dependencies. We'll have JPA, we'll add web dependency, we'll add Lombok, H2, and then click on generate. Now we'll be opening the project that we have downloaded. So as you can see, I'm already logged into my GitHub Copilot. This is the side activity bar where you'll get different suggestions from GitHub Copilot. Now let's create an entity class. We'll click on new, write down entity.student. We'll write down a prompt. Prompts can be given by just writing a single line comment. So GitHub Copilot will understand the context of my class and suggest me prompt that I have to write. To get this kind of suggestion from GitHub Copilot, it needs some training. That is, it needs to be trained about what all things you do in a particular class or from your repository. So now, as you can see, I have just added a comment and it has already given me a prompt suggestion like student class that have following fields, ID, name, age, address, phone, email. I just want to tell it that it's an entity class, student entity, I'll edit that. So here, ID will be the key for my student entity. So I'll make it as auto-generated. It is giving me a suggestion to use Lombok for getter and setter. To accept this suggestion, I'll press tab. Now, the prompt is ready. I'll just click on enter. So it is giving me multiple imports that I have to use. It's giving me imports for Jakarta, for persistent API, for entity, auto-generated, ID, and Lombok. So we'll click on the sidebar for this GitHub Copilot and click on refresh. Now, it will give you multiple suggestions about how you would like that class should look like. You can browse through all of them and choose. I've chosen the second one. So I'll remove these commented lines. Okay. Now, I want to add validation for the student object. Let's write down a prompt. At the start only, it has given me suggestion to add a method to validate the properties of the student entity. The method should return true if all the properties are valid and false if the properties are invalid. To accept the prompt, I'll press tab and then press on enter button. So I've got this whole validate method. It is validating name, age, address, phone, and email. But the validations are like null checks are there and age should be greater than 0. I want a better validation. So for email and phone, I'll write out another method. So let's give a prompt to add validation for phone number. Add a method to validate phone number. Now I've got this whole prompt and I'll just read it out. the method should return true if the phone number is valid and false if it's invalid. The phone number validation should be done via regex and should accept Indian phone number only. That's perfect prompt. I'll just select it by pressing tab and then click on enter. So I've got this whole method. There's a null check there and there's a regex match for 10 numbers. Yeah, perfect. Now let's validate our email also. Let's write down a prompt for validating email. Add a method to validate email. I guess again it will suggest me the correct prompt. The method should return true. Again, I've got the prompt. Okay. Return true if email is valid and false if the email is invalid. The email validation should be via regex. The email prompt is same as the prompt for phone number. Should accept Indian email only. I guess this is wrong. I'll just remove this Indian phone number only and then write down it should accept Gmail, Yahoo and Outlook. Again, a suggestion is there. I'll just accept it by pressing tab. And now I have got this whole method. Perfect. It is now accepting Gmail, Yahoo and Outlook email ID. This has saved a lot of time for writing this regex. Now in this validate method, let's add a call to validate phone and email. Again, I've got the session. I'll just accept it by pressing tab. Yes, it has added all the session and I have accepted them by pressing enter. I'll remove the if else for email and phone number there. Now this is how the class looks. This is perfect. Now let's create a repository. We'll click on new Java class repository dot student repository. So here I'll be using JP repository for writing down student repository, and this will be an interface. So again, I've got a suggestion to define a repository interface for student repository that extend JP repository. The repository should have these methods. The prompt looks good to me. I'll accept it. And now I have got the import methods. The studio type repository. So I'll go again to the sidebar, click on refresh. There are multiple options that are available for me. Let's choose the second one and we'll remove this commented lines of code. And as you can see, my student repository extends JP repository and the entity object is student and the ID is of type integer. So after creating this JP repository, what I have to do next is to create service class service dot student service. This will also be an interface. So I'll just remove this part and write down a prompt. Create an interface for student service that has the following method as create, delete, update and get. It is giving me imports that I have to do. I'll accept all those imports by pressing enter. And again, I'll go to GitHub Copilot there and click on refresh. Again, I've got multiple suggestions. This time I'll choose the first one. There's a missing curly brace at the end. I'll just apply that. Now I've got this perfect interface. Create is accepting student object. Everything's correct. So let's create an implementation method. We'll go to new Java class. And we'll write down student service ampl. Once I create this ampl, you can see I've got a suggestion to implement this method. Perfect. There's an auto suggestion that I'm getting, but I don't want that. If I choose that auto suggestion, then I have to implement those methods. But I'll give you a smarter way of doing it. Just write down a prompt to create a class service implementation that implements student service. And you can see all the methods are there. Now, what I want is student service should depend on student repository to do all the CRUD operations. And again, I've got a suggestion to do that. It should have a constructor that takes in student repository. Rather than constructor, I want to have an auto wiring with the student repository. Should use the student repository to perform CRUD operation. Perfect. I've got all the imports. I'll just accept them by pressing enter and tab and enter. Go to GitHub Copilot, click on refresh for the completion of code and I'll accept So it is giving me validation also in the first solution. You can browse through multiple answers and then select whatever suits good for you. I guess both are pretty much similar, except the second one. And yes, perfect service implementation. There's an auto-wired student repository is there. And the create method, you can see we have validating the student object. If the object is not valid, it's giving a runtime exception. There are multiple other methods, delete, update, get all. Now we'll be creating a controller class. Controller class will be calling student service. Click on new, select class, and write down controller.studentController. And again, I'll delete this line and write down create a class student controller that has method. Again, I've got a correct suggestion. I'll just accept it by pressing tab. It should use student service to perform CRUD operation. The prompt is similar to the student service prompt that I have given. Now I'll write down use correct HTTP methods for each of the methods and press enter. Again, I'm getting imports. I have imported that. Press tab and enter to import. We'll click on GitHub Copilot, click on refresh. And you can see there are multiple choices of the class completion that is there. For the first one looks good to me though. The second one is quite similar. I'll accept the first one. For the post mapping where we are saving the student, that is the create object that we have given. See, it has not handled any exception that could come up. If I show you within the student service class, I'll just go inside this interface. It throws a runtime exception when the student object is not valid. Before we do that, there's an exception in this class. I'll resolve that. And for this exception, I have to put in a curly brace at the end. I'll put that curly brace. So to add exception handling, I'll remove this student as return type and write down response entity of string as the return type. And then let's write down a prompt to return response entity. While writing the prompt, it has given me the correct solution. I don't have to write down anything. I'll just accept this prompt. I'll remove the last line. So it is doing a try catch block it has added. If the object is valid, it will return the 201. Else it will return a bad request. Now our controller class is built. It has all the methods, post mapping, delete mapping, get and put mapping. So now let's head over to application.properties. So in the application.properties, I want to tell Spring Boot that I'll be using in-memory database, that is H2 for saving. We'll write down hash add relevant properties to use H2 as the database for this application. For this Spring Boot application I'll write down and then press enter. Tab and enter. I've got URL for H2, tab and enter, driver, username, password, JPA, database. Perfect. I've got all the properties that are required. I'll remove the last one. I don't think that is required. I'll remove this one. And for the password, I'll write down password as the password. That is by default for H2. So we have added all the properties. Now let's get back to the main class and run this application. So it's parsing Java, scanning the files, and it is running. And there are no errors. Perfect. We haven't written any line of code and we have developed a full-fledged microservice. Let's go to PostMan and post this request. We'll click on send. Yes, we have added this object. Perfect. Now let's make this Gmail as different so that Gmail 1 I'm writing now. So it is giving me invalid object. Perfect. Now let's test it out with the Outlook. Click on send. Yes, it is added. Outlook and Gmail are accepted. Let's check out this get request, student of 1. I'm able to get this thing. For the second one also, I'm able to get. That is nice. Let's click on delete. Yeah, so I have deleted the second one. Now let's check out all the students that are there. Students is not there. Okay, without slash I have to put it. Yeah, I've got only one object because I have deleted the second one. That's it from my side. I have developed a full-fledged microservice without writing a single line of code. We have just given simple prompts. That's what I'm trying to emphasize on. So this is the future. You guys have to be ready for this.
That's all from my side. If you have any questions, feel free to comment below. I'll reply to all of them. If you liked our content, please like, share, and subscribe for more such videos. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.